Hello, I'm here to talk to you about the treatment of childhood constipation. If this problem is not treated appropriately, outcomes can be poor, and this can have an impact on the lives of children and young people for years to come. This presentation is based on NICE guidelines, which we know are often not implemented in practice. I'll run through them now. First line treatment at presentation is a Macrogoal solution. This will soften the stool by ensuring fluid is retained in the colon, which is then absorbed by the stool. 1 to 2 sachets should be an adequate maintenance dose. The effectiveness of the Macrogoal treatment should be reviewed after 6 weeks. If at presentation the history is prolonged, there is soiling, and an abdominal examination reveals a palpable mass, then disimpaction is recommended. This involves taking increasing doses of a paediatric Macrogoal solution to a maximum daily dose of 8 sachets for children aged 5 and under, and 12 sachets for children over 5 years. This equates to a daily total of 500 millilitres and 750 millilitres respectively when correctly reconstituted according to manufacturer's instructions. This should be divided between 3 or 4 drinks throughout the day. It's worth mentioning here that the soiling may get worse before it gets better, but it's important that the disimpaction regime is not stopped until the stool is watery, without any hard lumps, light brown, and inoffensive. The stool should remain in this state for 48 hours before the dose of paediatric Macrogoal solution is reduced to a maintenance dose of 2 sachets. There is no need to reduce the dose gradually, but the child should be reviewed on completion of the disimpaction regime to ensure that the process is complete. Following disimpaction due to physical changes to the rectum that occurs in long-term constipation, most children will need both daily paediatric Macrogoal solution to soften the stool and a stimulant medication such as Senna or sodium picosulfate to encourage full emptying of the bowel. For the child who does not require disimpaction, it may still be necessary to introduce a stimulant medication in addition to paediatric Macrogoal solution if this alone does not result in a bowel motion more than 4 times a week after 6 weeks of treatment. Rectal preparations should not be used as first-line treatment, and ideally, their use in children should be avoided outside of the hospital setting. The child should also be encouraged to sit on the toilet after meals to promote a regular bowel habit, and of course, a healthy diet and adequate clear fluid intake should also be promoted. If there is poor progress with this plan after 3 months, it is recommended that children are referred to a specialist service for management of their constipation.